Now we check in on the Alleghany Mountaineers with a record of 3-4, taking on the William Fleming Colonels at 5-1 in Roanoke. Two teams trying to get themselves set up here for the postseason race here as you look at William Fleming on the year. One of those teams in Roanoke that have been pretty good and maybe a tough outcome playoff time.
Yeah, certainly going to be an exciting matchup as early on as the pass is going to be picked off. And a great play defensively by William Fleming as they get going early, but one defensive play deserves another, and that pass is picked off by Tyler Brownman, and he coasts in the end zone for the first score of the game for the Mountaineers.
Brownman following up that pick by Warren Kraft, and now you see it's a two-point conversion, tricking the defense there, and converted by DeAndre Banks, and all of a sudden, Alleghany with an 8-point lead, looking to spring the upset.
Speaking of being sprung, it's Jesse Hill, shot out of a cannon down the sideline, and he scoots into the end zone for the touchdown. And after the extra point, it's going to be an 8-7 lead for Alleghany, but you see the offense is both looking strong in this one.
And you see a punt here now, and it'll be William Fleming getting it with one of their deadly return men. That's Malik Tranum. He's got room to run, and he will get there to the end zone. 59 yards for the touchdown, and Fleming is back where they want to be.
Great play by Tranum as he finds the end zone. And 14-8, your score, first quarter still, as Alleghany finds himself on defense facing the quarterback Deshaun Adams, and Adams looking deep downfield, and a great diving reception made as that was Warren Kraft with the excellent catch, and now Adams is going to roll to his left, continue rolling, buying time on third down, and finds his target in the back of the end zone as Najee Wade makes the catch. Looked like his right foot might have been on the back line there, but they're going to give him the credit for the score. 28-8. Your score in favor of William Fleming.
Well, Chris, the referees don't have the luxury of the replay like we have here on Sports Report, but those receivers doing damage, and Tranum, Wade, and Kraft, and you see special teams making an impact here for Alleghany, taking them in near the red zone, and now set up a field goal here for Alleghany, and they will get the kick up and good for Levi C, and that makes it 21-11 in favor of the Colonels in the third quarter.
We'll see how the Colonels respond defensively, and they're going to come up with a turnover here as the fumbled exchange between the quarterback and running back leads to the turnover, and that will lead to this as a handoff will go to Hill. Hill turns left and loses the football, but Johnny on the spot is his offensive lineman, Justin Jarrett, who makes a great play, keeping the ball with the Colonels and the drive alive.
Linemen like Jarrett, Tyshawn Walker, and Patrick Paker really stepping up for Fleming here. They need him too, otherwise it could allow Alleghany to get closer. And Deshaun Adams says, it's not going to happen on my watch, as he scrambles away from the pressure inside the 15-yard line. And now it's Alleghany with their passing attack here. It's going to be a pass from Brownman at wide receiver, and he's got a man down the field, Chris, as we got some trick plays working here for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, this is a huge play, Matt. Unfortunately, it's going to be called back for an illegal forward pass, as the double pass would have gotten the Mountaineers inside the William Fleming 30-yard line. Unfortunately, with the loss of down penalty, it kind of stalled the drive out for Alleghany, as that's also not going to help matters, as the sack comes from the blind side and takes down the quarterback, Matt Patterson.
That allows Jesse Hill to go back to work here running the football as he shows off his elusiveness and then some toughness here on the run as he piles forward for about 5-6 more yards before he's brought down nearly about 10 yards on that run there by Hill. Great toughness there.
Great effort, and hopefully the flag that was thrown wasn't for holding, as that would have been a run for naught. And again, the Alleghany defense stepping up, but D. Brown is going to go down, and Alleghany is going to find themselves in the L column in this one. 28-11, your final score in favor of the Colonels of William Fleming. Jerome Hill, 24 carries, 145 yards, and a touchdown on the ground for Christian Carter. 18 carries, 70 yards rushing in defeat for Alleghany.
Colonels now 6-1 on the year. Another team that's rolling out in Group 4A along with William Fleming is one of their rivals, GW Danville, a winner in the Piedmont District 50-33 over Magna Vista. As you see, Hunter Burns throwing 4 touchdowns, 241 yards. He ran for 3 scores. Malik Clements catching 3 of those touchdown passes, while Shalom McGuire throwing for 395 yards and 4 touchdowns for Magna Vista.
More scores now. Northside over Lord Botetourt, 33-21. Troy Jackson, 10 carries, 90 yards, 3 touchdowns on the ground. He added 48 yards through the air for Northside in the victory.
Defending 3A state champs moving along. How about Giles? They're a team that's going to be a threat come December in playoff time for sure. 76 points on Eastern Montgomery in their Three Rivers District win as Brett Whitlow runs for 4 touchdowns, 200 yards as the Spartans move their winning streak to 22 games on the year.